Now, reducing congestion on our roads gives you more time to spend with your family and brings more business and jobs to our state. We are going to upgrade U.S. Route 460 to make it a modern highway from Suffolk to Petersburg. We will widen Route 66 inside the Beltway. We'll get started on high-speed passenger rail from D.C. to Richmond to Hampton Roads. On these and other projects, we will not accept excuses anymore. We'll get dirt turned and projects moving by using public-private partnerships, market-based solutions, budget prioritization, and innovative technology. I will be a jobs governor. I will advance policies that will put Virginians to work. And my fellow Republicans, you know that our elections are always about choices. And this year, regardless of who the Democrats choose on June 9th, there will be a clear choice for Virginians going to the polls on November 3rd. I will offer big ideas and positive solutions, and we will be the party that embraces reform and says yes. On energy, our opponents will say no to offshore drilling, no to clean coal, no to more nuclear, and no to new jobs and investment that come with it. But when it comes to promoting energy independence, they'll just say no, and we'll just say yes. On the job-killing card check bill that threatens to undermine Virginia's right to work law, a cornerstone of our business success, our opponents will say no to protecting the secret ballot. No to safeguarding Virginia's right to work law. When it comes to keeping Virginia competitive, they'll just say no, and we'll just say yes. When it comes to educating our children, our opponents will say no to more educational choices, no to more charter schools, no to performance pay for our best and brightest teachers and principals who help our young people achieve excellence. When it comes to improving our schools, they'll just say no, and we'll just say yes. On the issue of government efficiency and spending, our opponents will say no to eliminating more government burdensome regulations, no to making government more simple and user-friendly, no to reducing unnecessary permits and fees and licenses and decals, no to reducing wasteful spending. When it comes to government accountability, they'll just say no, and we'll just say yes. There will be a clear choice in November. We'll offer positive and innovative solutions to create those jobs, provide greater freedom and opportunity for all Virginians. When it comes to Virginia's future and the need for changes in Richmond, we'll just say yes. And as we say yes, we will do so never losing sight of the values that we hold dear. In his first inaugural address, my favorite president, George Washington, issued words that echo throughout the ages. He said to the young nation, "The propitious smiles of heaven can never be expected to remain on a nation that disregards the eternal rules of order and right which heaven itself has ordained." In other words, values matter. character counts. Dr. Martin Luther King said it a different way. He said that people should be judged by the content of their character. A nation that does not have a people of charity, of faithfulness, of integrity, and sacrifice cannot long endure. Mr. Jefferson wrote that all men are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights, and among those are the pursuit of life and liberty and the pursuit of happiness. I believe, and I know you do too, that this great truth applies to every American, both born and unborn, and as your governor, I will be a defender of innocent human life. In forming the Constitution, our founders expressly protected the individual right of Americans to own firearms, and as governor, I will protect the Second Amendment to the U.S. Constitution. Our founders understood that the pursuit of happiness meant the right to own private property. And as your governor, I will continue to strengthen the private property rights of all Virginians. We must save the founders' vision of individual liberty. Now, my personal faith in God has given me a foundation for my life. My faith gives me a strong purpose and a hope for a brighter tomorrow. I know we can make Virginia better. I've seen the amazing results that can be achieved when people come together for the common good and don't care about who gets the credit. Now it is time to come together once again for the common good. Virginians want leaders who understand that God has planted in the human spirit a love for freedom and opportunity and justice and equality. They want leaders who embrace civility, who will reach out to bring in independents and Democrats and Republicans, who keep their promises and who get results for the people. And I will be that leader. We must dream big, we must act nobly, we must make progress. In Virginia, where our forefathers planted this great republic, anything is possible. My life has taught me that. Thanks to growing up in a middle-class neighborhood in Fairfax County, I learned the value of hard work and following the golden rule. Thanks to my faith, I have learned the great value of serving other people. Thanks to the United States Army, I got the discipline and education that has taken me farther than I ever imagined. And now I stand before you as your candidate for governor in the greatest state, in the greatest nation that the world has ever known. Thank you very much. God bless Virginia.